Hello, how is everything? In the last class, we have discussed epistasis. There are two types of epistasis: dominant epistasis, recessive epistasis. Dominant epistasis ratio is, Amal, dominant epistasis ratio, right? 12 is to 3 is to 1. Recessive epistasis ratio. Amal, Tariq. Tariq Nandana. Yes, good. That is 9 is to 3 is to 4. Today, let us discuss complementary gene interaction. Complementary gene interaction. It was studied by Bateson and Punnett. Bateson and Punnett, while working on sweet pea, and the sweet pea, Lathyrus odoratus. Lathyrus odoratus. Bateson and Punnett. While working on sweet pea, otherwise called Lathyrus odoratus, they found that the flower color, purple flower color, is produced by two dominant genes. It is very essential. Two dominant genes are very essential for the production of purple flowers in sweet pea. And they named as capital C gene and capital P gene. If any of these two genes absent, or both of them are absent, then they produce us white flowers. Then they produce us white flowers. Two dominant genes produce us a purple flower. If any one of them or both are absent, then they produce us white flowers. And then two varieties having white flowers with genotype capital C, small p into small c, capital P. These two varieties having white flowers, with the genotype, this one. So homozygous type, quite naturally it produces only one type of gamete, right? It produces only one type of gamete. And these gamete, they fuse together to produce F1 offspring. All the F1 offsprings were, purple flower. And here what happens, this capital gene seems to produce color base, while the capital P gene seems to effect for the formation of enzymes necessary for the production of purple flower. And this produces, F1 produces purple flowers, and this is heterozygous condition. This F1 offspring produces four types of gametes. What are the four types of gametes? Capital C, capital P, capital C, small p, small c, capital P, small c, small p. Could you follow me? The students are always confused while constructing this gamete formation. So it's very careful. The two characters are there, and these two characters are crossed. That capital C, capital P, capital C, small p, small c, capital P, small c, small p. Right? Then these F1 hybrids were self-fertilized, selves. What happens? It produced the next generation, F2 generation, second filial generation. In the second filial generation, no, the offsprings produced were purple and white, appeared in the ratio of 9:7. So the complementary gene interaction, the ratio is 9:7. Then what about the dominant epistaxis ratio? Yes, Nandana? What is the dominant epistaxis ratio? 12:3:1. What is the recessive epistaxis ratio? Coat color in mice, we have discussed in the last class. Yes, 9:3:4. And here the complementary gene interaction, the ratio is 9:7. How? We can draw a checkerboard. And here you have to draw 16 columns here. Yes. And gametes. What are the gametes? Capital C, capital P, capital C, small p, small c, capital P, small c, small p. Right? And here also capital C, capital P, capital C, small p, small c, capital P, and small c, small p. And maybe it is male or it is female. And cross takes place here. Capital C, capital C. Right? Capital C, capital C. Capital P, capital P. And capital C, capital C, capital P, small p. Capital C, small c, capital P, capital P. Capital C, small c, capital P, small p. Capital C, small c, capital P, small p. Capital C, small c, capital P, small p. Here also capital C, small c, capital P, small p. Capital C, small c, capital P, capital P. Capital C, capital C, capital P, small p. Yes. The nyan. And here it produces capital C, capital C, small p, small p. Capital C, small c, small p, small p. Small capital C, small c, small p, small p. Small c, capital P, capital P. Small c, capital P, small p. Small c, capital P, small p. Small c, small p, small p. The two dominant genes produces purple flowers. Then the small p produces only white flowers. Only white flowers. 7. So the ratio is 9:7. Any doubt in this? Could you follow me? Shall we move on to the next cross? Okay, good. So that much about the complementary gene interaction. Now, let us move on to the next cross, that is polymeric gene interaction. What is it? Polymeric gene interaction. Polymeric gene interaction. Here now, two dominant genes have similar effect when they are separate. Right? Two dominant genes, they have similar effect when they separate, but they produce enhanced effect when they come together. Such a type of interaction is called polymeric gene interaction. Could you follow me? two dominant genes have similar effect when they separate. Separately, they produce similar characters, but they produce an enhanced effect when they come together. A typical example for polymeric gene interaction studied by the fruit shape of summer squash. Fruit shape of summer squash. Have you heard about this summer squash? Abelia, summer squash. The last class, dominant epistaxis, we have seen this particular plant. Otherwise called Cucurbita pepo. Right? മത്തന്ന് നമ്മൾ പറഞ്ഞു. അതിൽ ഫ്രൂട്ട് കളറാണ് നമ്മൾ പഠിച്ചത്. വാട്ട് ആർ ദ ഫ്രൂട്ട് കളേഴ്സ് ദേ ഹാവ്? യെല്ലോ, വൈറ്റ് ആൻഡ് ഗ്രീൻ. ആരാ സ്റ്റഡി നടത്തിയത്? ഹൂ ഡിസ്കവേർഡ് സിന്നറ്റ് ആൻഡ് ദർഹ. സിന്നറ്റ് ആൻഡ് ദർഹ സ്റ്റഡീഡ് ഫ്രൂട്ട് കളർ. And here the polymeric gene interaction, here the typical example is fruit shape. In summer squash, otherwise called Cucurbita pepo, there are three types of fruits. One is disc shaped, another is a spherical, and another one is long shaped one, longer ones. These are the three shapes. Disc shape, spherical shaped and longer shaped. And here the disc shape is controlled by two dominant genes. And spear shaped is controlled by either a capital A gene or a capital G, capital B gene. And both of them are in recessive condition, it produces long fruited variety. When a disc-shaped fruit variety was crossed with a long-fruited variety, what happens? See, a disc-shaped fruit-shaped variety was crossed with a long-shaped fruit variety. Small a with the genotype, capital A, capital A, capital B, capital B, and small a, small a, small b, small b. This is disc fruit shaped, and this is long fruit shape. It's quite natural, it's a homozygous condition, it produces only one type of gamete, right? Only one type of gamete it fuses to produce in the F1 generation. In the F1 generation, all the F1 offsprings were disc fruited one. Are you clear? Any doubt in this? Then, this disc fruit shaped F1 offsprings produced four types of gametes. What are they? Capital A, capital B. Capital A, small b. Small a, capital B, and small a, small b. When these F1 hybrids were self-fertilized, selfed, and the F2 progeny was raised, in the F2 offsprings, disc, long, and spherical fruit-shaped offsprings were appeared in the ratio of 9:6:1. So the polymeric gene interaction, the ratio is 9:6:1. How it is? We can draw a checkerboard. See? Columns. Gametes, capital A, capital B, capital A, small b, small a, capital B, small a, small b. Here also capital A, capital B, capital A, small b, small a, capital B, small a, small b.
These are all gametes. Whenever you write gametes, you put a circle. Then here, this may be male or this may be female. Cross together, capital A, capital A, capital A, capital B, likewise. Capital A, capital A, capital B, small b, capital A, small a, capital B, capital B, capital A, small a, capital B, small 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 b, capital A, small a, capital B, capital B, capital A, capital A, capital B, small b, and here capital A, and small b, right? And here A, b, b, 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 and here a, capital B, small b, and here a, b, b. And here, three, and these three, six, right? This nine, these six, one, two, three, four, five. One more. Where it is? What are the six? One, two, three, four, five, six, right? And these six, one, two, three, four, five, six. These six are having only one dominant gene, so they produce a spherical shape. And here it is spherical shape. And here is a disc shape. And here it is now long shaped one. So that is the ratio is 9 is to 6 is to 1. And this is now it is the modified dihybrid ratio of 9 is to 3 is to 3 is to 1. But the two last two are combined together, it produces a phenotype. That is why it is called 9 is to 6 is to 1. So that is the polymeric gene interaction. Today we have discussed complementary gene interaction and polymeric gene interaction. In complementary gene interaction, you will get 9 is to, what is the ratio of complementary gene interaction? Complementary gene interaction, what is the ratio? You forget. Okay, then what is the ratio of polymeric gene interaction? That is 9 is to 6 is to 1. Earlier, 9 is to 7, right? Appo idaan nammal kandathu. Appo dominant epistatic ratio 12 is to 3 is to 1, recessive epistasis 9 is to 3 is to 4, complementary gene interaction 9 is to 7, and polymeric gene interaction 9 is to 6 is to 1. Any doubt in this? Shall we stop today? We can see in the next class another gene interaction. Have a nice day. Thank you.